council has ordered the necropolis sealed. I could purge the corruption from the Awakened with a little more time. But they will not listen. They call the Ember's effect a curse and feign concern for the peaceful rest of our ancestors. But fear alone guides them. If the Council refuses to accept the blessings of eternal life, we will keep the Ember for ourselves. Woe to any who disturb our sanctuary!
Level. You've released the Overseer from his madness. Now we can investigate his library. Ah, here are his notes. He mentions searching for an ember forge in a dwarven fortress, much deeper in this mountain. He believed it would cleanse the corruption from his awakened ancestors. I will return here another time to learn more, but this ember forge sounds promising. Come, let's go further down. We may not have much time.
The beauty of these sunken gardens shines through an age of dust and decay. Why did they fall to ruin? Could the same corruption that affects me now be responsible for this centuries-old destruction? The thought that this blight could be so ancient unnerves me, but if it consumes me, I must go deep enough that I can never escape to do harm. And there is still hope, a fool's hope. But I cling to it.
These ruins, I've read of them. This is Estheria. Their discoveries are the foundation of my art. Oh, I wish Brink could see this. I have reactivated these three rune gates, but it is the fourth that leads deeper. Some threat must have caused the Estherians to disable it. The destination glyphs are missing. We'll need to find those missing glyphs to continue. Search the active gates while I study this chamber. Hurry, there are many obstacles between us and the Ember Forge below.
You have gained a task. Thank you.